Hi, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about how to minimize EMF exposure, or EMR, so electromagnetic radiation or fields exposure. We know that we're inundated with EMFs from all of our modern world and technology. So whether it's our cell phones, whether it's our tablets, our laptops, it could even be baby monitors, our Wi-Fi routers, anything that is plugged in, even an induction stove, believe it or not, gives off EMFs. And it's something that I've measured in my office and in my home. I just got a little EMF reader. There are different types, and this is not a fancy one. There are definitely better ones, but this gives you an indication. And I was shocked to find out some of my exposures, even in my own environment, and you know, things that I could actually change and move away from and unplug certain things in my home and in my office to be able to protect myself. So what else can we do? Well, in other videos, I've talked about some supplements that we can take to help to protect ourselves, some things that we can do with our diet and foods to eat to help to protect ourselves from EMF radiation. But today I'm talking about something different. And one of the things that we can do, and if we can do this daily, is called grounding. So grounding means getting out into nature, preferably with bare feet. And the grass is great, especially first thing in the morning when it has dew and it's a little bit moist, because we know that, of course, liquids increase the conductivity of our electromagnetic system. Because as humans, we are electromagnetic, and the way that our blood flows and the water in our body, the way that our brain works, our circadian rhythms are all based on this proper electromagnetic flow and of our electrons and our protons in our body. So really important that we ground our energy, and by doing that, by walking barefooted on the grass, you could also do this on a beach, so the sand has that same impact for helping to ground our energy. So what doesn't work is if you have rubber soles on your shoes, and this is something that I was guilty of even in my own home for years, wearing my slippers in the house that had a rubber sole, not so good for grounding. So I make a huge effort to get outside into the grass with my bare feet, and for about 20 minutes, once, even twice a day is much better to help to ground your energy. But this is really, really helpful to decrease that negative impact of those EMFs on our body. Now, if you've got the leather sole shoes, this is definitely okay. And I always, you know, wondered about socks. So yes, socks are okay as well, if they're cotton, natural fiber, of course. And if your feet are a little bit sweaty, then that actually helps with that grounding impact. You can also ground yourself on ceramic tiles if they're not specially coated. So if it's just the, you know, the ceramic and natural surfaces, so concrete as well, you are able to ground yourself again with, if you've got bare feet, hopefully there's not been when the concrete was laid out. If there is a plastic barrier, then that will minimize your ability to ground. But do your best. If you look at animals in nature, if you look at a dog that sort of rolls around on his back in the dirt, in the grass, that is an essence of grounding as well. So always look to nature. Nature gives us so many signs and signals of the things that we should be doing to keep ourselves healthy, because we are animals as well. Another thing is exercise. So we know that exercise has so many benefits, but also for EMF exposure and to decrease that risk of damaging our cells. And what exercise does is it helps our oxygenation, but it also improves our nitric oxide. And nitric oxide is something that in the right amounts is like a stressor in the body, but in the right amounts can be very helpful at protecting our cells, because then our body has to react to that nitric oxide and allow for the cascade of that antioxidant effect to actually happen in our body. So one of the things that I love, and I've talked about in a previous video, is Bfr training. So blood flow restriction training. It's when you strap bands around your upper arm, above your biceps, and above your quads, and it partially restricts the blood flow so that it is helping to increase that nitric oxide, helps to increase that pump in the muscle and get that activation of that muscle fiber and the building of the muscle fiber. And you do this again for usually not more than 20 minutes, where you are wearing the bands, and of course you don't want to fully restrict that blood flow. flow. You still have to be able to have your function to be able to lift your weights. But one of the advantages, especially as we're aging, is that older individuals usually do not lift the heaviest weights to decrease the likelihood of injuring yourself. So you can actually lift much lighter weights and still get the same benefit in that muscle growth without, you know, having to lift those heavy weights with the bands when you're using the Bfr training. So thanks for joining me today. Those were some great tips on how to minimize the negative impacts of EMFs on our body and that radiation exposure. Check out our other videos as well on this topic. We have a full 1 hour episode on the Dr. Janine Show in part one and part two of this whole, you know, subject around EMFs and how to protect ourselves and how to do it naturally. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor. Leave your questions and comments below. I'd love to hear from you. Give me a big thumbs up on this video. Make sure that you're subscribed and share this video with some other friends of yours who you think might be able to benefit from this important information and do your best to live your healthiest life and do it naturally.